And I thought, you know what? I could have a nice week off from creating content this week. It's like, nah. No, Reese. No. So to recap, we was meant to be getting Anthony Joshua versus Tyson Fury. After months and months of negotiations, we finally got two provisional dates. We had August the 7th or August the 14th in the obvious location of Saudi Arabia. Both fighters agreed that August the 14th would be the chosen date, and we had a fight on our hands, people. The unified heavyweight division was about to commence on August the 14th. And as that was all going on, Deontay Wilder was in the process of going through the courts to ensure he gets a third fight. He wins that fight, and now instead of the August the 14th Anthony Joshua and Tyson Fury fight, we now have a Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury fight number 3. The confirmed destination is Las Vegas. And you know what? As frustrating as it is, it's probably a good thing. Hear me out. It's been a while since Tyson Fury last fought. A long while. His last fight was against Deontay Wilder. If he was to go into the AJ fight, the last time AJ fought was December, and it was against Pulev. Tyson Fury would have had the obvious ring rust, and I just do not want any excuses for when the AJ and Tyson Fury fight happens. I don't want to hear, well, Tyson Fury was out for so many months, and that's the reason he lost the fight. I just want it clear as day who was the winner, and that is it. That should then push the fight between AJ and Deontay Wilder to December. Hoping that there's no injuries, that gives enough breathing room for Tyson Fury to get rid of any ring rust and come off a big win against Deontay Wilder to then go on to unify the division. In the meantime, as frustrated as Anthony Joshua is, and has a right to be, by the way, I bet they were told that the Deontay Wilder issue was nothing and they didn't have to worry about it. It was going for the courts, but they would win. But for that to slap them in the face last minute, I would be fuming. I would genuinely be angry. But now he'll probably have to fight Alexander Usyk, a dangerous fight for him. But again, it gives him also the opportunity to have that warm-up fight before the Tyson Fury fight. Final reason why I think it's a good idea this fight is taking place is so we can finally put to bed the Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury saga. Deontay Wilder has come out and made claims that his water was spiked and that his suit was too heavy, all sorts of craziness. And if Tyson Fury wins this fight, that's it, it's done. Done with Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder. I do not want to see these two in a ring again. I'm done with it. I like Deontay Wilder, but I do not want to keep seeing him fight the same people. I'm not interested. Go and fight Andy Ruiz. That's the fight I want to see for Deontay Wilder. Or better that, Dillian White. And the final reason is less to do with Tyson Fury and more to Deontay Wilder. And I just want to see him fight again. I want him to prove me wrong. Because I don't think his water was spiked and I don't think his suit was too heavy. I just think he was beaten and probably beaten by a true heavyweight in Tyson Fury. Deontay Wilder was outclassed that night. He has a lot to prove. If he loses again, that's it. It's game over for him. His career's done. He'll be too dangerous to fight. He'll be in the Dillian White camp where they just struggle to get fights because they're so dangerous. And actually the very last one, I've thought of just one more now. I'm glad that it's delayed because it means we can have a little bit more hype. There should be no excuses. There should be no contract issues. There should be no dilemmas. We should just have a straightforward fight. And the focus from now up until December is that we are talking about this fight. There's promotion, there's marketing. The guys have met up with each other. Do the whole Conor McGregor and Floyd Mayweather thing where you went to all parts of the world to do press conferences. This is the biggest fight in the world right now and it should be advertised everywhere. It should be marketed everywhere. The fact that they were just gonna throw it in August with very little hype and very little excitement, I'm kind of glad it's delayed. It sounds crazy, but I am, the more I think about it. With everything that is going on around the world, Tyson Fury and Anthony Joshua was that one thing us boxing fans were looking forward to. We've just gotta wait a little bit longer now. We've got to see the positives. I'm just hoping that Deontay Wilder does not beat Tyson Fury. Same with Alexander Usyk. It's nothing against Usyk, it's nothing against Wilder. I just want to see Fury versus AJ. That's the fight I want. It has the better ring to it. British Unification Heavyweight title on the line. Doesn't get any better than that. Who knows, it might even give them more time to organize a second fight. The last time they were doing the organizations, they could only get down for one fight. They've got plenty of time now to organize two fights, one in Saudi Arabia, one at Wembley. As I've said in many videos, I'm fine with Saudi Arabia being the first location for the fight. I understand you gotta make your money, but that second fight needs to be here in Britain. Two British fighters that have been backed by the British public should be here fighting in the UK. That's how I feel about that. But what do you guys think? Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury, who wins? And are you excited for it? Let me know in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe to the channel because you'd be helping me out massively. Take care, guys. Peace.